see the vision, you can see the targets. So this is a good formula in presentations. So you can see your forecasting and budgeting and all. So how to make this in a simple way, I'm going to show you. This is the replication of the same. So I'm going to show the expert and the simple formula. So the expert formula is like, if you need a conditional formatting. So now if you select, there is nothing been selected. So you can directly go to the conditional formatting, a new rule, and you can select and you can type the formula here. But before going here, you have to try and test your formulas in the simple way. So the formula is like match. I'm going to show you a mistake in this formula. I'm going to select this one. So see what a mistake actually we people do in selecting this. So 1, 2, and 3, comma, and the lookup array is like the whole area. I'm going to select this. I'm going to log this F4, comma, 0. I'm going to close the parenthesis. This is showing the area of the second one. But I want to match this with the area over here and log this also. So it's showing me a false. So if I select this into, still it's a false. So make this true, it comes to a true. Now I can copy this formula. I'm going to copy this and hit escape and then go to new rules. I'm going to select here and I'm going to hit paste. So now after this, I can do is format. I can select the color, do okay. But this has been not selected. The formula is there, but it has been not selected. So the problem is, go to manage rule and you can see this is not applied. This is the main area. The formula area is this one. You can double click this or you can edit it and you can see the formula area. But the main area is the apply, so where it has to be applied. So either you can duplicate this also. You can say you have duplicated this. So you can delete this also. So you can make this up and down. So you can have some sort of execution. You can stop it if it's true, or you can select this, but I'm not going to go on that. So I'm going to delete this. So I'm going to select it. You can select it from here either, or you can hit this so you can get more space. Now if you want to select, you can see if you want to select this, you have to move this. So you just, this easy way is just select this and select the whole area and till here and go back and apply and do okay. But you can see when I selected 2, it is not going select correct selection because there is an error in the formula. There are 2 errors. So first one is, I'm going to go to manage rules and I'm going to do this works edit rule. So this is a wrong. So that it has given as 10, it is wrong because when we selected here, it went to a wrong direction. So again, I'm going to copy and paste it and do okay and apply and okay. But still there is a wrong. This is the second error I am done. So when I'm selecting 10, it is showing 9. When I'm selecting 14, it is showing 13. So if again, if I go to the formulas and manage this selection, and if you want to reduce by 1 and apply this, still the problem is not solved. You can see there is a mistake. So it is going 2 places back. Even if you go back again and manage rule selection, edit it, and +1. So now it is going the correct one. But this is not the correct way. You should not be doing adding or plus, deducting and all. So this is not the correct way. So the correct way is, when you're selecting the formula, export formula, you have to be very careful. So I'm going to show you how to first clear this. I'm going to clear rule from the entire sheet. You can clear from here, or you can go to manage rule. You can select the worksheet and delete from here. So now I can delete from here and apply and do okay. So when you select this, always see that you have selected not this one, you have to select from the beginning. So you should have, otherwise you should keep on adding 1 plus or 1 minus. So if you take from this side, so the best way is to select the right one, and that either you can do this or you can just pull this up. So you can see whenever you pull up and down, the things change over here. So just pull this block and move to the top one and just hit enter. So anyhow, this is giving false, but when you select the one, it is giving true because the correct area has been selected. So you should always select from this one, copy this, copy, now escape. Now make a new rule. So before making a new rule, I would like to show you, just select this whole area in the beginning only. So you need to select again and again. Now go to conditional formatting. Now make a new rule and just go and space this here, and just do the format and just select this one and do OK and do OK. So you can see that when I select the things, automatically the things are getting selected. So this is an expert formula. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to do this in the other formulas, which is a very simple formula also. So we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.